I think a couple of things have happened. MCC is still alive and well. There has been some movement to restructure the financial sector and how we do development overseas. MCC is a part of that conversation. It's called the Build Act. Mm-hmm. If your constituent would go to the website and look at MCC, they're a part of this new process where we're looking at how we structure foreign development going forth. The MCC's budget, I think, has come down. It's about close to $1 billion a year still. And they're continuing to do compacts and subcompacts. And I think Ghana has been a recipient of two. They're in their second compact now. I think it's an energy, which is one of the areas that is most important to Ghana to moving it from an economic development perspective to stop the brownouts.
And at one time, as a matter of fact, I think they were one of the leading countries in terms of accessing, you know, the grants. And they still remain very democratic, so it seems to me that they still qualify.
But yeah, they still qualify. They're still finishing up, if I believe. I don't have the data in front of me at this moment, but I know that they're finishing up their second compact, which is an energy compact on distribution and generation, which you notice you don't hear about a lot of the brownouts in Ghana anymore because they're starting to curb some of the problems that were existing from local production as well as generation. So I think over the next year, you'll see much more clarity from the government in regards to its assistance program. But the Build Act is one, and I think MCC is still very much involved in providing compacts to countries to help move them to the next level from an economic development perspective.